Without anything to do in the club room, we get our bags and go to the courtyard. And that's all that's left to do is to go home. Has to be something. Must be somewhere.
もういいんです、岡崎さん。約束しましたから、杉坂さんと。だから、もう演劇部は作らないです。
You didn't make any promise like that. You just said you weren't going to interfere with the chorus.
岡崎さん。
What?
とても楽しかったです。
What was?
一緒に頑張れて、です。目的は達成されなかったですけど、もっと大切ないろいろなものを手に入れました。岡崎さんととても仲良しになれました。
Wait, is this the scene I'm thinking of?
篠原さんとも仲良くなれました。こんな私でもです。こんな不器用で泣き虫な。
Right. You know, Ferga, you're getting a lot stronger. A lot stronger than when you were at the bottom of that hill, weren't you? Might be clumsy or crybaby, but you worked hard to get to where you are. I was able to worry about others, I worked hard too.
本当でしょうか?
Yeah, I really felt like that. Yep.
だったら、嬉しいです。私は…体は弱いですが、くじけないように、強い子になろうと生きてきたんですから。
Suddenly tears spill out of Fergal's eyes.
嬉しいです。よかったです。
And then, putting her face in her hands and onto her eyes, she begins to cry. I put my hand on Fergal's head.
またですか?
Do 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 do. I don't know what choice to make here. I don't really know. I feel like this choice is really gonna leave an impact here. Well, obviously, I mean, that seemed like a big one. Should we stay like this or embrace her? And where will it lead? Where will it lead? The tough decisions.Fuck it, just go for it and be in CG form. Finally get to see what Tomoya looks like. He's got blue hair. So how come Fuku doesn't say, hey, strange hair person? He's got unnatural hair color. Blue is not a natural hair color. I mean, Sunohara dyes his head blonde, but that is a natural hair color outside of Japan. My body moved on its own, hugging Virgo from behind.
そんなこと…しないでほしいです。そうされると、安心して泣いてしまいます。
Aren't you crying already?
そうですけど、もっと泣いてしまいます。
It's alright, you ought to cry when you feel sad. Virgil continued to cry for a while. I felt as if I wanted to stay like this forever. What, with her crying?I really do care for her, as I involuntarily put my hand on her head. But I really wanted to be closer to comfort her. Small existence that supported me, which I really wanted to support. I wanted her, what? I wanted to her to be comforted. That's not grammatically correct. Hey, Ferga.
Hi.
If we wake up tomorrow morning, and we become lovers, wouldn't that be interesting?I just knew it would have to end this way, wouldn't it? It's gonna be weird, man, if it... I mean, this still could potentially get derailed for all I know. I have no clue. I had the boyfriend and the other girlfriend. But surely I have a fun school life. Don't you think so?
思わないです。と、 何をやっても失敗する私に腹が立ちます。岡崎さん。どうしてですか?
Because I like you, Freya. I confessed as such. That's why I'm sure such things will not happen.
本当でしょうか? 自信ないです。
It will surely be fun, or rather, I'll make it fun.
そんな… 岡崎さんだけ頑張らないでください。 私にも… 頑張らせてください。
You know what? Kind of abrupt, but I'm gonna check that guide thing again. I wanna see, just to be sure. So a moment. That's surprising. So, looking at the guide, even though we've gone with the Embracer choice, which continues Nagisa's route, it is still actually possible to get Fuku's route. She has two separate endings. Like an A and a B kind of ending. Apparently, we can get the B one, but not the A one. And there's still freaking Komoro's one lurking in the background ready to overtake and ruin everything. It's still there. I think those are the only ones. I also looked through Sonohara's sister's route. I'm pretty sure that one was sealed off long ago. Like that choice where we looked at the window pretty much sealed the deal on that one. Actually, come to think of it, if that's the case, then maybe that ending could actually be possible on the other save. It's like, I was just thinking, oh, it's probably going to be Yukine's, but, well, no, I think there was a choice earlier on than that as well that probably would have derailed that. So the other playthrough would probably just lead... I don't even know. I have no idea what to expect from Isla. It's like, this is all one playthrough, but it's got two different save files because I got picky with my choices. With, like, halfway through, well, yeah, about halfway through, I guess, I suppose. I see. So, imagine that! This, like, oh yes, Tomoya confesses that he has feelings for Nagisa, and then it ends on the Komoro end. It would come out of left field, and it does, it really does come out of left field. I remember years ago when I did the playthrough, because I went through like every scene over and over again for each playthrough, and like Komoro's route was like, I can't even remember how many parts, but there's a lot of parts, only for this really short, brief ending that just kind of comes out of nowhere. It was weird. So, Fergara, would you agree to my request? Be my girlfriend, Fergara. For a short while, she didn't turn around, nor did she nod her head. Just a tiny voice could be heard. Please, take good care of me. Dick, I thought it was a yes then. It's a Friday! Oh, it's a Friday today, actually, as I'm recording this as well. Oh, how much of a contrast is that? Emotional music, he confesses her love, next day, wakes up so bright. Ooh. It's different. I buried my head under the blanket once more and dozed off. Since I've been going to class seriously recently, I guess it's okay to be late this one time. There's a drama club thing too, but the result was no good. Guess it's on hold. Suddenly I recall Fergara's face. She's in my arms. I could faithfully remember all the details of that place, and the way the sun was shining to the shadows of the trees. How small the shoulders that I embraced were, the scent of her hair that I could smell from being so close to her. Then in my arms, Fergara gives a small nod, saying, please take care of me. I suddenly jumped awake. That's right. I confess my love to her. That I'm up at this early hour, now we become lovers. Who'd have thought? It still feels like a dream. Is this for real? I look at the clock on my wall. Crap. Even though I may have enough time, that doesn't stop me from running. Once my legs stopped moving, it felt like I would just stop right there. Just my girlfriend. Once I fully understood that, it began to feel like a burden. What? But as if something was tingling a part of my heart, I feel happy at the same time. It's what they call love, it's what they call the butterflies in your stomach. Ah, stop thinking. Well, it could be love, or maybe it's not. Well, it's probably love in this case, because, well, it's a freaking novel. Of course it's gotta be. Run! I can do nothing but run with all of my energy into a wall or a tree. In the middle of all the students, one girl clearly stood out. I mean, she certainly would with that hairstyle, really, think about it. That really does stand out. I mean, imagine that hair in real life. How would that even work? She's here. Instead of rushing over, I catch my breath. Somehow my heart's throbbing. I begin to walk next to my girlfriend. He must be, like, freaking out in his mind now. He's like, holy shit, is this really happening? Is this for real? Hey, morning.
Ohayou gozaimasu, Okazaki-san.
This is awkward. Yeah, understandable. I can see why. I have to say something or else she might just start unknowingly fawning over me. But I wonder what she's really thinking. I wonder if she's really thinking of me as her boyfriend signed from today. I wonder if she really believes the promise we made yesterday. Well, it wasn't really a promise, was it? Or was it? What are we talking about again? It's her, after all. She might have thought that they were just words of comfort and didn't believe them at all. Or maybe. In order not to hurt me, she just gave me that response. Right now, she wants to just tell me to forget everything that happened and is just desperately trying to get on the strength to us. Hey, Fergar.
Hoi, nandeshou?
She's the same old Fergar. I feel a little relieved. It's done.
So desu. Deva ikimashou.
No, I'm just like now remembering now. Cause like, it's, I remember like, back when I LP'd Clannad, who's like the stark contrasts between his interactions with each of them, each girl essentially. And it felt like, and I guess it makes sense how Tomoya got her own spin-off one, because it felt like, of all of them, like relationship-wise, they seem to have the most chemistry, really. And then there's the other ones where there was chemistry, certainly, but it felt like with Tomoya and Tomoya, the names are even similar, but well, they probably have very different meanings to the names, obviously, I imagine, but whatever. They kind of had more of a natural kind of relationship thing. I know, it felt like it ran smoothly. Well, it wasn't smooth because, of course, got bumps in the road, don't you? And I don't mean those bumps, no. Don't get the wrong impression there. Although they did kiss a lot. It's just like, just comparing that, essentially, to how the canon girl, Nagisa and Tomoya, and just like, it's just such a bizarre relationship. Seriously, if you've seen Clannad and After Story, or, you know, read the novel yourself, you know what I mean. It's just so different compared to every other one. It kind of like, I don't know. I guess the closest I can think of is maybe Kotomi, I guess. In a kind of similar fashion. You can also look with Fuku as well, but Fuku's one is quite different. There's not really much to do with that, really, a relationship. Bit of a spoiler, kind of saying that, isn't it? But kinda not really, but yeah. But it's just weird how different their relationship is compared to all the other ones. And it's the canon routes. Yeah. We start to walk, and then I guess she didn't believe it. I guess it's kind of that thing, isn't it? It's like in these kind of novels, it's just like, people just like, oh, they prefer, they like kind of ship the protagonist with one of the other characters rather than the main character, because there's more chemistry there. It's like, think of like Kyo and Tomoya, the interactions. Sure, she's always mostly hostile towards him, but she's like a tsundere kind of character. So of course, there's just like, oh there, and then there's Tomoya and Tomoya. Or heck, maybe even Tomoya and Katomi. Or something, you know? And, no, it just feels like the chemistry between Tomoya and Nagisa is kind of an awkward one. But anyways, I've been rambling on here, then I guess she didn't believe it. We stop at the bottom of the slope!
どうしましたか?
Lots of students begin to pass us and climb the slope. I wasn't just trying to comfort you.
何をですか?
What I said yesterday. Have a frog out, thanks for a little.
Hi.
Still looking down, she answered.
どんなパンを食べようかってもう考えないできました
You can't tell if she's just not oblivious to it or if like or if she's just trying to dodge the question. Because if she's oblivious, that's kind of funny in a way. Remember Dark Opera 2? How bloody ridiculously oblivious the protagonist was to every girl's feelings. It's kind of like a role reversal now. It's like the protagonist is the one that's kind of like trying to get their feelings across, and the girl that he's showing his feelings for is just kind of like, I was thinking about what bread I'd have for lunch. Just completely oblivious! This must be what all those girls in Dark Up 2 must have felt like with... I can't even remember the bloody name of the protagonist in Dark Up 2. But Blandy McBlandface. They must have been so annoyed by how oblivious he was.
でも今日からは別の楽しみができましたから、そのことを考えてきました。
Oh? About what?
岡崎さんが彼氏で、私がその彼女で。
She isn't as oblivious as I thought. Said Kanojo, right? Is that what he means? It girlfriend is Kanojo. I'd always wonder that. Enter. Enter.
そんな学校生活が始まることをです。それが楽しみで来れました。
A corner of my heart feels ticklish once again. Oh, really?
でも、思っていたのとは少し違いました。What
was?
楽しいのとは少し違いました。不安でした。 半分楽しくて、半分不安でした。
Yeah, that sounds about right.
本当に、私なんかでいいのかなって。
Are you still seeing things like that?
それは、岡崎さんは背も高くてかっこよくて素敵な人です。なのに私は泣き虫で引っ込み思案で。
Hey, Furga.
Hi.
How do you feel if I start to say bad things about the big dang family from whom you love and said they weren't cute? Wouldn't you? I feel like that right now.
Hi.
I love a girl named Furga Nagisa. Please not say bad things about her.
Oh, hi. すみませんでした。
I let out a burst of laughter. It seems like Virgo still doesn't understand what she said. Must be her imagination. Come on, let's go. We'll be late. I mean, I've been rambling here for a long time. We begin to climb the hill. Later, Virgo.
はい。
I find it weird. They've known each other for a short time and all, but at the same time, it's kind of like they're still talking to each other, referring to each other by last name. And for crying out loud, Kyo refers to Tomoya as Tomoya. She doesn't even add anything to it, it's just Tomoya. Well, to be fair, there is a reason for that. Because I think that Kyo has known Tomoya for at least a year or so, or maybe more. It's like, it goes into more details, I think, in her app. Because they're not like childhood friends or anything like that. It's more of, there have been familiar terms for a couple of years because they're going to civil school, obviously. Can I call you Nagisa from now on? Oh, and he finally addresses it.
Hi. Watashimo Tomoya-san te yonde ii desu ka?
Yeah, of course. Kun is fine instead of san.
Tomoya-kun desu ka? Kawaii desu.
I bet. My feet felt light, and then he realized he slipped on his ass. Never thought that today would come when I'd climb this hill feeling like this. I can hear the sound of a bowl being tossed back and forth. Ah, yes. I remember this. This will lead to the important grand finale. Depending how it plays out. But even then, I have no idea. I can't even remember how long this is. I mean, it's still freaking Friday here. There's still freaking Sonohara's sister paying a visit on the Saturday, so the next day. And I remember, because she... It depends. If you pick to answer the phone, she ends up coming over. And you kind of have a scene and all that. But it's not, like, super important to the plot. It doesn't actually go into her route unless you've, I suppose, kind of picked choices that don't latch you onto other routes. Such as Nagisa's. Or, I suppose Kotomi's one could be another one. Because once you latch onto that, it kind of probably kicks out a lot of other routes, I imagine. Because if you haven't noticed, we haven't seen Kotomi since that one time we met her. Because all the other choices have led it so that we've never gone back to the library since. And it's the same with Yukine. We chose to look out the window, see Nagisa, and we haven't gone back to the reference room since. But reload the other save file, where I chose not to do that, and freaking go straight to the reference room not long after. It's just like those choices, man. They can kick off a route pretty easily. It's complex. Play off this part.
Thank you.
Wow. Kinda got carried away there. But anyways, see you next time, viewers. See you next time.